Alright, so in this video, we are going to learn about adding video and audio to our HTML page. So before starting, there's the first thing that you should always do. We also saw this in Bitstack. You should always create a folder with all the media in it, all the videos that I want to upload, and I'll create a separate folder for it. I'll not mix it with the other files. Whenever I need, I'll add it from here. Okay? So it's easy for our browser to load rather than searching for the file everywhere and going to the exact location. Now, title I've given here is video elements in HTML. Okay, so now first we'll see how to add a video. That's very simple. It's just like image tag. First thing we'll do is video. Then we write src, that is a source. Now this three types of format that any browser will mostly support. The first format is WebMHD. The second is MP4, and the third is OG Theora. Now you guys might not have heard about WebMHD and OG Theora, but you've heard it. Nice. So these are the types of video formats, video files that they are available in. Now we are going to see about MP4 file. Okay, we are going to see about MP4 files. Now in this source, we'll add a path. So the path I have is video. /dot MP4. Okay, you can see this has appeared here. Now is this video playing? Can you hear the sound? Can you see motion? No, right? Because it won't play until we add an attribute called as autoplay. As soon as we add, okay. Now you can see this. You saw there was motion. Now the video started playing. Now if I remove this autoplay, again the video will stop. Now before adding autoplay, you have to add one more attribute called as controls. What this does is, you can see the changes, right? Gives us this play button, this mute button, and then this full screen button. Okay, and we can start the video from wherever we want. This is what controls provide us. After this, we'll add autoplay button. Now, after this, you can see as soon as I add autoplay, it starts playing. Okay, now next thing we'll add is the width. Give it a width of 500px. Again, give it a height of 500px. For right now, I'll just remove this autoplay option. You understood the use of autoplay, so I'll just remove it from here. Because the video starts playing and then it disturbs my sound, you cannot hear me properly. And then we'll close this video tag with another closing tag. Okay, so this is the format to add a video to our browser. You can see that this video has been added to our browser. Now, what is you want to add all the three formats? You want to add MP4, you want to add OG Theora, you want to add WebMHD. If someone's browser supports OG Theora, then you should have OG Theora. If someone's browser supports WebMHD, then your site should play that video, right? If your site doesn't play that video, then user cannot see your video. So how do we add all the three types to our single video tag? So what we'll do is, we'll give it a video tag here. Now we'll not add source. First thing we'll add is controls, then we'll add width, and there's one more thing that we're going to see here. We'll add height. Height will also be 500px, and the next thing we're going to see is called as poster, or you might know this as thumbnail. How to add a thumbnail or a poster to our video? Again, we'll add video. I've already added an image here. You can see latteposter.jpg. I'll add latteposter.jpg. Okay, you can see that this has appeared here. This is the thumbnail of my video. Now I'll close this. Now I'll add a closing video tag, and inside this video tag, I'll add another tag that is called as source tag. And here in source, we'll add attribute that is called as src. We have source tag, and then we have the source attribute inside this source tag. And in this attribute, we'll write the source, the path of the first file, latte4.mp4. We'll start with video /latte4.mp4. Okay, we'll add one more attribute, which is called the type attribute. Here we'll write video /mp4. We'll close this again. Now you can see, let me show you the difference between the type. You can see that this is MP4, right? Now look at the quality. The quality of MP4. It's pretty clear, right? Now my browser supports MP4, so it will play MP4. Now the next thing that I want to add is OG Kiora. Again, source RC video SK for dot OGG Kiora dot OGV. Again, we'll add one more type attribute video as OGV. We'll close this off. Now we'll just copy this. We'll add the last type is WebMHD. Dot web. Here we'll add webm. Okay, and we'll save this. Now, why did we add all of these? And again, if your browser uses something else, your browser does not support any of the three, then you can write your browser not support this. So playback. You can just write this. You guys may have seen this many of the times. Okay. So why did we write all of these three formats? The reason is someone's browser supports MP4, then our video will play in MP4 format. If someone's browser does not support MP4 and it supports OG Kiora, then our browser will play this video file. And if someone's browser does not support MP4 and OG Kiora, then it will play this WebMHD file. Okay, so this was the reason that we wrote all of these three sources and we added all of the three video formats. Now let's save this. Let's open it up in our browser. Refresh this. Now you can see that video has appeared. To play the video, you can see the video plays. You can mute, you can reduce the volume, you can use full screen. Okay, all of the features are available. That was it about adding a video. Now there are many more functions which you can see if you want to learn about video. There are many functions that you can add. Suppose if the CSS style kit, if you want to change appearances of the video, but for HTML, this was it, adding a video. Now the next thing that we were going to see was adding a audio. Now if you want to use audio attribute, what you have to do is just simply add this tag audio, and in the source attribute, write the path of the file that you want to use, and then close this tag off. Close this audio tag off. Okay, that's it. That's it for audio tag. You require nothing more. You can see requires a source. It does not require a width. This does not require a height. It does not require a poster image. Just add the source. Now, incidentally, I don't have a audio file to show you how it works. But all types of audio formats the browser supports, you can add them like this. The same way you have added it here. You can add source, then SRC, and then all types of format. And then you can add a audio to your web page. That was it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next video.